हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम कमलेश नंदिता जयवन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन फिजिक्स, आर्ट्स साइंस एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज रामनगर बुरली, एंड आई एम हियर टू टीच पेपर नंबर 9 फ्रॉम बीएससी फिजिक्स थर्ड ईयर, एंड द टॉपिक दैट आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टुडे इज पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस. ओके, सो हेडिंग ऑफ द चैप्टर इज पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस. Okay, so when we start this chapter, as per the protocol, we will go for the definition of differential equation and how do I define differential equation. Basically, in the lecture today, we are going to study various definitions, various properties that a differential equation follows, and then we are going to look for a method. The method is of suppression of variables, method of suppression of variables that is used to solve this partial differential equations. Coming back to the point, how will I define differential equation? So, an equation involving independent and dependent variables. So, it will involve independent and dependent variables. Now, what are these independent and dependent variables? You might have studied integration, derivatives and all this part. So, in derivatives, what do we say? Differentiating y with respect to x, that is what we say, differentiating y with respect to x. So when I say that I am differentiating y with respect to x, so that means this y is differentiable with respect to x. So then this y is a dependent quantity and x is an independent quantity. So in a partial differential equation, we will have both independent and dependent variables, and derivatives we will have both independent and dependent variables, but the derivatives will be of dependent variables with respect to one or more independent variables. So what are we basically going to do is we are going to take derivative of dependent variables with respect to independent variables, and that is what we call as differential equation, a equation that is formed with dependent and independent variables, and where derivatives of independent variables with respect of dependent variables with respect to independent variables is involved is what we call as differential equation. The definition is sophisticated and much easier. Okay, so if I take some examples of partial differential equations or differential equations, the example is going to be, let's say, dy by dx is equal to 1 plus x upon 1 minus x. It can be d2y by dx square is equal to 2 times dy by dx minus 8y is equal to 0, or it can also be there's a minus sign here, d2y by dx square minus 2 dy by dx minus 8y is equal to 0, or it can be d2y by dt square equals minus kx. So these are all examples of differential equations. Okay, so what do we do basically with partial differential equations or with differential equations is we try and solve them, and the solution of differential equation is a relation between dependent and independent variables. How am I defining this solution? A solution is relation between independent and dependent variables. And what do we have next is, which when substituted in the equations will give you an identity. So every partial differentiation or every independent variable will have an identity which relates this independent variable with dependent variable, and that is what I call as solution. And what we basically do with a partial derivative is that we try and solve it, and we try and determine the identity which relates this independent and dependent variable. Okay? So after this basic definitions of differential equation and the solution of differential equation, let us move on to the types of differential equations. Basically, differential equations are distributed into two. These two types are just let me erase the board. So these two types of differential equations are ordinary differential equation, which I also abbreviate as ODE, and the second type that we have is partial differential equation. Okay, I can write it as PDE. I can abbreviate it as PDE. Okay, so when we talk about ordinary differential equation, this equation will involve derivatives with respect to single independent variable. So we will have derivations. Of course, we have derivations. Just a minute. So derivations with respect to single independent variable. Let's say for example, we will have dy by dx minus dy is equal to e raised to x, or we can have this dy by dx which is equal to sin x plus cos x. So we have differentiation, we are differentiating the dependent variable with respect to independent variable, but this differentiation is taken only with respect to single independent variable. So the difference is of course clear. What is going to be the case for partial differential equation? Here derivatives will be involved, but these derivatives will be with respect to one or more, mostly more than one, I must say, more than one independent variables. More than one independent variables. Okay? So when such a condition occurs, or when the equation involves derivatives with respect to more than one independent variables, so that is what I will call as partial differential equation. Now, what is example? Let's say this d2v by dx square plus d2v by dy square plus d2v by dz square is equal to 0. What do I see? I am differentiating this v with respect to x, differentiating v again with respect to y, and differentiating v with respect to z. So this type of equations is what we call as partial differential equations. I can take one more example, like d2y by dx square is equal to c square d2y by dt square. Now we of course know that this is an equation of progressive wave, differential equation for progressive wave, and we are going to solve this in the last part of the chapter, but for now this is an example of partial differential equation. That is what you need to remember for the moment. Okay, so this is example of ordinary differential equation, this is an example of partial differential equation. After discussing types of differential equations, we can talk about various phenomena that are related to a differential equation, the first being order of differential equation. Okay, so how do we determine order of a differential equation? I'll just clean the board. Okay. So the next heading or the next point that we are going to discuss is order of differential equation. Order of differential equation. And how do I define order of differential equation? It is highest order of derivative, highest order of derivative, derivative of differential equation. So how am I defining order? I am saying highest order of derivative of differential equation is what we call as order. okay, or the equation involved. You can just add words as per convenience. If you don't write it, also it's fine. So let's say I have an example. This is my example. And with this, with respect to this definition, we'll see what is going to be the order of this equation. Plus 2y is equal to x squared. Now see, what I say, highest order of derivative of differential equation. I have this differential equation and the highest order of derivative, what do I see? What is the highest order of this derivative? This is 3 here. Highest order of this derivative, this is 1. 0 and 0. So, highest order of derivative of differential equation involved is what we call as order. So, it is clear that order of this equation is 3. Now let us consider one more example for our convenience, nothing else. So this is the example that I consider. 5 d2y by dx square plus 4 dy by dx plus 5 integration y dx is equal to 6x. So when we try solving this equation, the thing that you need to consider for knowing the order of the differential equation is that there should be no differentiation equation, there should be no differentiation symbol or integration symbol or any fraction involved into it. So what do I need to do? I need to solve this integration part. So if I solve this integration part, what will happen is the power of all the differentials will raise by 1. So see, this is going to be 5 d cube by dx cube plus 4 d2y by dx square plus 5y is equal to 6x squared. This is going to be your final, this is going to be your final form of differential equation. Now let us talk about the order. Order here is 3, order here is 2, order here is 0, and order here again is 0. And what is the highest order of derivative of differential equation involved? It is 3. So this is again differential equation of order. So I want you all to remember this fact, that no symbol of integration or derivative should be involved, no fraction should be involved, and only then what we can get is the order of differential equation. The next part that we have is degree of differential equation. So after discussing order, we are going to discuss about degree. Okay? After discussing this degree, we have got to discuss linearity and homogeneity of differential equation. That also we will do soon. So the next part is degree. Degree of differential equation. Okay. So when I talk about degree of differential equation, how am I defining it? It is highest power of highest order derivative. Highest power, this is not highest order, this is highest power of highest order, highest power of highest order derivative present, derivative present or derivative involved in the differential equation, in the differential equation. Okay, so what I am saying here is highest power of highest order of derivative present in the differential equation is what I define as degree. So let's say for example I have this by dx square minus 3x dy by dx plus 2y is equal to x square. So this is my equation, and what we have said is we need to remove the radicals, and we need to remove the radicals, and we need to remove the fractions. As I can see, there are no radicals, there are no fractions, so I do not need to remove anything. I just need to check the degree. What it says, highest power of highest order. What is the highest order do we have here? We have order 2, order 1 here. Now see, this is raised to 6. Now see, highest order and highest power of this order. What is highest power of this highest order? It is 1. And therefore, this is degree one differential equation, 1 degree differential equation. You may get confused that 6 is the highest power. Though it is the highest power, what we need to consider is the highest order and power of this highest order. So power of highest order is 1, and therefore the degree is going to be 1. It is not going to be 6. Just remember that. So after discussing about degree of differential equation, we will talk about two properties of differential equation. The one is linearity of differential equation and other is homogeneity of differential equation. So the first part is, the first property that we are going to study is linearity of a differential equation. Now what is linearity of a differential equation? How do I define it? Let us talk about the definition of linearity of differential equation. Heading is linearity. Linearity of differential equation. Okay. How am I defining it? A differential equation in which dependent variables and all its derivatives occur in first degree only. So see, I have a differential equation. I have a differential equation, and in which, in this differential equation, the dependent variables and its derivatives occur in first degree only without product. You need to remember each and every sentence, each and every statement that I am writing here. Without product of dependent variables. And derivatives. So this is the definition. I will explain this definition with the help of an example. All I am saying is, a differential equation in which dependent variables and its derivative occur in first degree only without product of dependent variables and derivatives. Now see, how am I going to put this? Divide by dx. This is first order. This is first order, first degree. First degree because highest order has got power 1. Sin x plus cos x. Okay. Now let's take for example dy d2y by dx square plus xy is equal to x square. Now the order here is 2, but degree is again 1. So the degree equal is only 1, and what do we have is degree equal is 1, and the equation which is of degree 1 without product or independent dependent variables and derivatives is what we call as linear differential equation. So these two are examples of linear differential equations. And then the last part for today's topic that we have is homogeneity of differential equation. Okay, so let us talk of homogeneity of a differential equation. How am I going to define it? These are basic definitions that you need to know when we are trying to solve partial differential equations or differential equations of any kind. So Rahul, your point complete karte hain log. Okay, so the next point that we have is homogeneity of a differential equation. How do I say that an equation is homogeneous or non-homogeneous? Okay, so there are two conditions that we need to remember. So suppose like we have a function or we have a derivative or a differential equation of the form dy by dx f of small f of xy upon phi of xy is equal to f of x, let's say. Capital F of x. So if I have a differential equation of this form, then I will call this equation as homogeneous only if degree of f of xy and phi of xy is same. So if the degrees of both the equations are same, only then I can call it as homogeneous equation. And how can I expand this? I can expand it like this. See, f naught of x gn of y upon dx raised to n plus f1 of x d raised to n minus 1 of y upon dx raised to n minus 1. We can just continue with the equation, and this is going to be f of n minus 1 of x dy right means. So as long as, so this is plus y f of x is equal to capital F of x. This is the differential equation that I have. Now for this differential equation, if my RHS is equal to 0, first definition, definition is that degree of this two have to be same. Second condition is that if the equation is represented in this format, then if the RHS is equal to 0, then you call it as homogeneous. And if the RHS is equal to 0, then it is homogeneous. If the RHS is not equal to 0, in that case we call it as non-homogeneous. So remember this. If your equation is of this format, then numerator and denominator have got to get same degrees. If you have got a differential equation of this format, then the RHS, if it is equal to 0, then you call it as homogeneous equation, and if it is not equal to 0, you will call it as non-homogeneous equation. This is the part that we have covered till now, and the next point that I am going to discuss today is a method used to solve these differential equations, and that method is called as method of separation of variables. So heading for the day is method of separation of variables. Yes. Now see, so when we talk about method of separation of variables, I want to assure you that it is a very easy, very efficient method. This method has been developed by very renowned scientists like D.L. Eppert, Bernoulli and Euler. Okay? And what does this method do? This method converts partial differential equation into ordinary differential equation. And why do we convert partial differential equation into ordinary differential equation? Is because we have got set of solutions, or we have got harmonic equations for ordinary differential equations. The solutions are already present, and depending upon what format of operator we have or what format of equation we have in operator form will define the solution itself. Okay, so if we have like n variables in the equation, I say if we have got n variables in the equation, we will need to select n minus 1 constants when we are solving or when we are trying to get a solution by using this method of separation of variables. Okay, so there are various steps involved that we need to follow in order to solve any differential equation, any partial differential equation, by the method of separation of variables. Okay, so once we are known with this, known with the fact that there are various methods that can be used to solve a differential equation, and one of them is this method of separation of variables, let us just move on and talk about the steps that are involved in solving this partial differential equation. Okay, so instead of just revising these steps, I will just go with an example that will make understanding easier. Okay. Okay. So now let us talk about the steps involved into it. The steps involved are, first, assume that differential equation is product of two functions. Now we need to consider this differential equation. Let us consider Laplace's equation. So the Laplace's equation is del square phi is equal to 0. Now I won't go into clarification of what a Laplace's equation is, what is Laplace's equation is, what are its applications, what are its properties. That we will discuss in the next lecture. The next lecture we will devote it completely to two-dimensional equation for Laplace's, or two-dimensional Laplace's equation. We will solve it by this method in Cartesian coordinate system. But today we will just take it as an example so that we can understand the steps that are involved while solving any partial differential equation. Okay, so let us say that this is my Laplace's equation, and I can write this equation as dabba 2 phi by dabba x square plus dabba 2 phi by dabba y square is equal to 0. Now, the first step that is involved says that assume that differential equation is product of functions, each of which involve only one of the independent variable. What does that mean? I have to assume some solution phi of xy which is product of dependent variables. So x of x and y of y. So this will be only belonging to x. This will only be belonging to y. X will belong only to x. Y will belong only to y. So this is the solution that I am assuming. Next step that we have to do is substitute this assumed solution into the equation number. So when I substitute this value here, what it is going to be? This is your step 2. We are substituting. So see, this is going to be dabba 2 by dabba x square of xy plus dabba 2 by dabba y square of xy is equal to 0. Now remember, if you have got a x here, then this y is going to be a constant. If I am differentiating with respect to y, then your x is going to be constant. So what will we do? We will just take out these constants. So the constant is going to be y dabba 2 x by dabba x square plus x dabba 2 y by dabba y square. Now once you have taken these constants outside, the next thing or the next step that we will do is we will divide this with the product of solution. So simply you are going to divide this y by xy, dabba 2 x by dabba x square, and then again you are going to divide x with xy, dabba 2 y, capital Y here, by dabba y square. I am always equating it equal to 0 because I am considering Laplace's equation. Now what do we get? 1 upon x, dabba 2 x by dabba x square plus 1 upon y, dabba 2 y by dabba y square. Now see what miracle have we done here. This involves all x's, this involves all y's. Okay, so we have some way managed to convert partial or differential equation into ordinary differential equation. So once we do this, the next step that is involved is substituting a constant to each of ordinary differential equation. So let's say 1 upon x dabba 2 x by dabba x square, and I put it as c1, some constant, and 1 upon y dabba 2y by dabba y square is equal to c2. And what is going to be my condition? The RH is equal to 0, therefore c1 plus c2 is equal to 0 is the essential condition that I need to consider. So what have you done? You simply have converted a partial differential equation into an ordinary differential equation. And once we have done this, we know that ordinary differential equations have got their own sets of solutions. So we can simply put solutions to these equations once we write their operator form. And this way we are going to solve any given partial differential equation with the help of method of separation of variables. So I hope that you have understood the ways or the method which we are going to use to solve Laplace's equation, which we are going to use to solve it in two dimensions and then into three dimensions. And lastly, we will be solving the differential equation of progressive wave again by the same method. So I want you all to go through all the steps that I have told, consider the example that I have given, and in the next lecture we will again talk about the same method, the same example in two dimensions Cartesian coordinate system. I stop here. Thank you.